of Vivekananda PU College in Commerce Stream. I welcome you to this online classes. Myself, Sridhar Shettigar, lecturer in Commerce. As we know, in this academic year, total educational activities are uncertain. But we must have some approach towards our subject. Yes, therefore, this is the attempt of online classes. After completion of your SSLC, you had the options like arts, science, commerce, out of which you opted, selected commerce. I think you have the particular goal or particular distance. For the purpose of reaching that target, we lecturer and you student must work together. I hope you cooperate. Further, after completion of your SSLC, you had many institutions to learn your PU studies. At you opt, you select this Vivekananda PU College. Therefore, you kept and your parent kept a parents are keeping some confidence to this educational institution. Let us work together. See, here in this video, I will discuss about one of the subjects, that is business studies. Okay, business studies. In first, let us know what are the various content or syllabus. The first one, nature and purpose of the business. First chapter, nature and purpose of the business. Second one, forms of business organization. See, in this chapter, nature and purpose of the business, we will study what is the meaning of business, what are the features of the business, and further what are the types of the business, and further what is business risk, and what are the different business risks are. Second one, forms of business organization. Here we are going to study the various forms of business management. Means it may be one owner business, which is called sole trading concern, or it may be partnership firm, a collective ownership of two or more persons, or it may be joint stock company, or it may be cooperative society, or the various forms of business organization. Next one, private, public and global enterprise. Third chapter, private, public and global enterprise. See here, private means the business that is owned by private individuals. It may be sole trading concern or partnership firm. Public means it is the business which is owned and managed by the government. For example, government companies or departmental undertaking or statutory company, etc. The various public sector. And third, global enterprise means those enterprises which is owned and managed by two or more countries. Antarrashtriyavadantha vyapara. Second business, fourth chapter is business service. In business service, business include other services like banking, insurance, transportation, warehousing, or communication, etc. The various business service we are required to study in business service chapter. Next, emerging mode of business. Emerging mode means the contemporary issue in the business. Emerging mode antandre business na vartamanada belavanigegalu, aadhunika business na yenu hosatana ide, so adanno emerging mode chapter alli study maartare. Next one, social responsibility of business. See here, this is our basic assumption that business means earning of profit. Yes, business is the object of earning profit, but it is also have the social responsibility. Vyaparakkiruvantaha samajika javabdarigalu adara bagge naavu illi study maadtare. Next, formation of a company. Formation of company means ಒಂದು ಜಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಕಂಪನಿಯನ್ನು ಸ್ಥಾಪನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಲೀಗಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ಸ್, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲೀಗಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಎನ್ನುವ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ದ ಏಟ್ ಒನ್, ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಸಿನೆಸ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಸ್. ಸಿ, ದಿ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಸಿನೆಸ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಬಿಸಿನೆಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಆರಂಭಿಸಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಫೈನಾನ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು. ನೋ ಡೌಟ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಿಸಿನೆಸ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಸ್. ಹಣವನ್ನ ಸಂಗ್ರಹ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ಗಳಿವೆ. ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಶೇರ್ಸ್, or it may be debenture, or it may be retained earning, or it may be bank loan, or it may be loan from financial institution. Many sources are there. Yes, let us discuss about sources of finance in that 8th chapter. 9th one, small business. Here, small business means it is small scale industries. Okay, sanna gatrada kaigarikegalu adara bagge na small business alli study martive. And what are the different government support for the purpose of formation of small business is studied in the 9th chapter. 10th one, internal trade, antarika vyapara. See, internal trade means the trade within the country, ondu deshada olagade nadeyuvanta vyapara. What are the types of it, what are the merits of it, what are the different demerits of it, to be studied in the internal trade chapter. Next, 11th one, international business 1. In international business 1, we will study what are the different modes or forms of international business. Antarrashtriya vyaparavannu madlikke yavella possibilities ide, antarrashtriya vadanta vyapara madlikke vanta bere bere margagalu athava daarigalenu, that is to be studied in the international business chapter. And another one, international business 2. This is international business 1. Next one, international business 2. Here, in the case of international business 2, in last chapter, we will study what are the different import and export procedure. ಒಂದು ದೇಶದಿಂದ ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ಆಮದು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ದೇಶಕ್ಕೆ ವಸ್ತುವನ್ನು ರಫ್ತು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಂಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಯಾಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಟು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ 12 ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಬಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ COVID-19 ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನೋ ಐಡಿಯಾ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ limitation of a syllabus depending upon the time availability in this academic year. Anyhow, these are the various content. Yes, now let us start from this first chapter to a short duration, that is nature. First chapter, nature and purpose. Nature and purpose of a business. Nature and purpose of a business. See here, the introductory part, introduction, for the purpose of satisfying our needs, namige enadru beku anta idre athava nama aasegalanna naavu idirisikolbekadre, in society we are doing or we are going to see the various activities. Manusha bere bere tannadantha chatuvatikegalanna maartane. I repeat, for the purpose of satisfying of our needs, okay, we are going to do the various activities. Now, bere bere activity anna maartteve. Such an activities of human being broadly classified into two. One, non-economic activity. Non-economic activity. Non-economic activity. Another one is economic. Okay, economic activity. Economic activity. The activities of the society are activities of the human being divided into two. One non-economic activity, another one is economic activity. See here, non-economic activity means those activities of human being not for the purpose of earning income or wealth or money, but for the purpose of love or affection or sympathy. So that is called non-economic activity. Now ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಯಾವುದೇ activity ಹಣ ಗಳಿಸುವ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಸಂಪತ್ತನ್ನು ಗಳಿಸುವಂತಹ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಇಲ್ಲದೆ ಪ್ರೀತಿಗಾಗಿ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬನ ಸಮಾಧಾನಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬನ ಅನುಕಂಪ ಅಥವಾ ಅನುಕರಣೆಗೆ ಅವನನ್ನು ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಮಾಡುವುದಕ್ಕೆ, ಮಾನಸಿಕವಾಗಿ ಅವನನ್ನು ತೃಪ್ತಿ ಮಾಡುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಯಾವ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೋ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ನಾನ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ನಾಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಮನಿ ಆರ್ ವೆಲ್ತ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್. ಸಂಪತ್ತನ್ನು ಗಳಿಸುವಂತ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಅದರ ಹಿಂದೆ ಇರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಬಟ್ ಸಚ್ ಆನ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡನ್ ಬೈ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲವ್ ಆರ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿಂಪತಿ. ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬನ ಮೇಲೆ ಅನುಕರಣೆಯಿಂದ ಅಥವಾ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬನ ಪ್ರೀತಿಗಾಗಿ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹದ್ದು. ಹಣ ಗಳಿಸುವ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ನಾನ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ, ಹೆಲ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ರೋಡ್. ಹೆಲ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಟು ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ರೋಡ್. ಒಬ್ಬ ವೃದ್ಧನಿಗೆ, ವಯಸ್ಸಾದವನಿಗೆ ರೋಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ದಾಟಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವನಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ನಾನ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆನ್ ಸಿಂಪತಿ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್. ಅವನ ಮೇಲೆ ನಮಗಿರುವಂತಹ ಅನುಕಂಪ a food by the housewife for the family. Okay, grihini maneyalli yenu aduge maartallo, so that is called non economic activity. It is because she is doing cooking work in the family for the purpose of satisfying the needs of family, not for the purpose of sale. Avulu maduvanta aduge adu maneya sadasyara trutigagi maduvantadu avaranu samadhanaka maduvantadu horatha adu maratakkagi alla. So that is called non economic activity. But cooking food at hotel is economic activity. Hotel alli aduge maartaralva adu economic activity, yakantandre adu hana galisalike bekagi maduvantadu. So non economic activity means those activity which are doing with the purpose of love or sympathy and without the intention of making money or resource. The second one, economic activity. So economic activity means those activities of society for the purpose of earning money or income in the form of profit or salary or wages or commission, etc. So that is called economic activity. ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಚಟುವಟಿಕೆ, ಅದು ಹಣ ಗಳಿಸುವ ಉದ್ದೇಶಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು. ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಲಿವ್ಲಿಹುಡ್, ಓಕೆ, ಜೀವನವನ್ನು ನಡೆಸುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತಹ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಅನ್ನು ಗಳಿಸುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ದ ಮೇನ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಅರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಆರ್ ಅರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಮನಿ ಆರ್ ಅರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ವೆಲ್ತ್, ಹಣ ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು, ಸಂಪತ್ತು ಮಾಡುವಂತದ್ದು, ಅದು ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿಯ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. Such an income may be in the form of profit, or it may be commission, or it may be rent, or it may be wages, okay, or it may be the commission, etc. So on the other hand, the income is one. Anyhow, economic activity means the employees of the office, they are doing economic activity. One office is one, the employee is one, the chatwati ke economic activity, because employees are working for the purpose of getting their salary. Or doctor operating in a clinic, ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲಿನಿಕ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಆಪರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫೀಸ್. ಆರ್ ಎ ಆಟೋ ಡ್ರೈವರ್, ಈ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಡನ್ ಬೈ ದ ಆಟೋ ಡ್ರೈವರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಟು ದ ಪ್ಯಾಸೆಂಜರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫ್ಯಾನ್, ಓಕೆ, ನಾಟ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್, ಧರ್ಮಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದಲ್ಲ. Or it may be the business man, okay, business man maduvanta business, that is to earn the income in the form of profit, which is economic activity. Or it may be the teachers, okay, we teachers are doing economic activity because we are doing our profession, okay, or our employment for the purpose of earning income in the form of salary. So anyhow, such activities are called economic activity. Okay, I hope you understood the two classifications of human activity of the society, one non-economic activity and economic activity. So non-economic activity is not governed by earning of income, it is just because of love or sympathy or affection, whereas economic activity means those activities for the purpose of earning income or money or wealth. So our subject is economic activity because business is a economic activity. See, let us discuss about economic activity. Economic activity further divided into three. Economic activity further divided into three. One, business. Okay, business. Another one, profession. Profession. Another one is employment. Okay, business, profession and employment. Business, profession and employment. What is this business? So business means, in its literal sense, business means in literal sense or in a basic sense, a activity of human being where business man himself is busy is called business. ಯಾವ ಚಟುವಟಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮನುಷ್ಯ ತುಂಬಾ ಬಿಸಿ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾನೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಬಿಸಿನೆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲಿಟರಲ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಸೆನ್ಸ್, ಬಿಸಿನೆಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್, ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್, ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ for a price and satisfying human needs and satisfying human needs. See here, business means either production or purchase and sale of goods and services. So business used to produce the goods or purchase the goods, not for the purpose of self use of the businessman. No, business produce or purchase and thereby its sale, adu mattobarige marata madutade, goods and services, saraku mattu seveyannu for a price, okay, not free of cost. That is non economic activity. So business is economic activity in which either goods produced or purchased and sale of goods and services for a price. What do you mean by price? For a amount, okay, for a money, for a price, and satisfy human needs. So manushana aasayana ideerisuvantaddu athava manushana aasayana tripti padisuvantaddu, so that is called a business. I repeat, economic activity further divided into three: one business, another one is profession, next one is employment. Business, vyapara, business that is vyavahara, okay, the profession that is naukari, whereas employment means that is udyoga, okay, vyavahara, naukari, udyoga, enna classification agutte. Whereas business in its simple sense, production or purchase and sale of goods and services for a price and satisfying human needs. Manushana aasayana tripti padisuvudakkagi saraku mattu sevegalanna ondu belege adannu sale maduvantaddu, modalu adannu purchase madikolluvantaddu, okay, so that is called a business. Now let us discuss another meaning of a business. See here, business is an economic activity. Business, another meaning, innond artha, business is an economic activity. Business is an economic activity concerned with the production, with the production and sale of goods and services undertaken for the purpose of earning profit by satisfying human needs. Anyway, see here, business is a economic activity. Earlier we studied two activities, one economic activity, another one is non-economic activity. Business is economic activity because business is done with the purpose of earning profit. ಅದೊಂದು ಆರ್ಥಿಕವಾದಂತಹ ಚಟುವಟಿಕೆ. ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೇಲ್. ಸಿ ಅಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಸೇಲ್ ದ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್. ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಡೀಲ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್, ವೆರೆ ಸಮ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಡೀಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್. ಕೆಲವು ವಸ್ತು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ಗಳು ವಸ್ತುಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾರಾಟ ಮಾಡುತ್ತದೆ, ಕೆಲವು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ಗಳು ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನು ಕೊಡುತ್ತದೆ. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಎ ವೆಜಿಟೇಬಲ್ ಮರ್ಚೆಂಟ್, ಎ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮರ್ಚೆಂಟ್, ಎ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ವೇರ್ ಶಾಪ್ ಎಟ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಸೇಲ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್. ವೆರೆಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್, ಇನ್ಶೂರೆನ್ಸ್, ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟೇಶನ್ ಕಂಪನಿ, ಓಕೆ, ವ್ಯಾರ್ ಹೌಸಿಂಗ್, ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಶನ್ ಎಟ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ ದ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೇಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಫಿಟ್. ಸೊ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ with the intention of earning profit by satisfying human needs. Okay, the ultimate target or ultimate goal of business is satisfying human wants. Manushana aasayanna ideerisuvantaddu adu business na ultimate target, okay, antimavadanta uddesha. Anyhow, whatever the goods or service that is demanded by the society, producing the same and supplying the same and thereby getting profit, which is called a business. So business in Kannada, it is called vyavahara, not vyapara, okay, vyavahara. Vyapara means trade. So vyavahara andre eno, business studies in Kannada, it is called as vyavahara adhyayana. for the purpose of earning profit by satisfying human needs, which is called a business. I hope you understood the meaning of business. As I said earlier, economic activity further divided into three. One business, okay, second one is a profession, next one is employment. Now let us discuss about what is a profession. Okay, what is profession? Naukari andre enu anta. See, profession means a provision of expert services, provision of expert services to the client for a charge called fees. For a charge called fees. See, profession antare provision of expert service, provision of not general service, it is expert service, vishesha parinati ullantaha seveyanna koduvantaddu to the client, okay, customer, to the giraki, client, for a charge called fees. One fees ige one expert service anna koduvantaddu, so that is called a profession. So profession means it is provision of expert service or specialized service. So expert service means it is a specialized service, vishesha parinati inda padedantaha seveyanna client ge kottu avaninda fees anna padkolluvantaddu, so that is called a profession. Example for profession, that is doctors, or it may be lawyers, or it may be engineers, or it may be chartered accountant, or it may be astrologer. Okay, so ivarellaru kuda doctors, lawyers, engineers, chartered accountant, astrologers are providing expert service. Avaru koduvantaha service adon vishesha parinati ullantaha service aagutade, it is not general service. By the formal education, ಒಂದು ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ನ ಮೂಲಕ ಅವರು ಪಡೆದಂತಹ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣದಿಂದ ಆ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಅವರು ಕೊಡುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಓಕೆ, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೊವಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟ್ ಸರ್ವಿಸ್ ಟು ದ ಕ್ಲೈಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫೀಸ್. ಇನ್ ಅದರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಂಡರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಇಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ. Which is economic activity? Profession. Profession is a economic activity in which specialized service is given by experts to the client for a charge called fees. For a charge called fees, which is called a profession. So profession is an economic activity. If business also economic activity, profession also economic activity, and next one is employment also economic activity. So profession means it is an economic activity in which specialized service, an expert service is given by experts. Okay, experts, vishesha parinati ullavaru. To the client for a charge called fees. One fees ige specialized service anna client ge kododakke profession anta helvantadu. For example, doctors, lawyers, or engineers, or it may be chartered accountant. For example, chartered accountant providing the expert service of maintenance of account to his client, that is businessman. Oba businessman ige oba chartered accountant vishesha parinati ulla seveyanna kodutane. In the same way, in the case of doctors are giving the specialized knowledge or treatment to the client, that is patient, for a charge called fees, which is called profession. And third one is employment. Okay, employment. Next one is employment. So here the employment also a economic activity. Employment also a economic activity. So in employment, employee giving service to the employer under provision of or giving of the service to the service given by employee to the employer under contract basis. See here, contract basis means it may be 1 month or it may be 6 month or it may be 1 year. For example, salary related to 1 month, it is a contract of 1 month, okay, or it may be for 1 year. So employment means employee giving service to the employer under contract basis for the remuneration called salary, wages or commission. Salary, wages or commission ಗೆ ಒಬ್ಬ employee ತನ್ನ employer ಗೆ, employee means worker, okay, employer means boss, okay, ಒಬ್ಬ employer ಗೆ ಕೊಡುವಂತ ಸೇವೆಯನ್ನ employment ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಬಹುದು. Example for employment is it may be office clerks, okay, are doing their work for salary, or it may be bank employees or teachers or the employees of the organization, and laborers, because laborers are getting wages under contract basis for a particular duration. So these are the various examples for this employment. So in this session we discussed about human activity broadly classified into two types. One economic activity, another one is non-economic activity. Economic activity are undertaken with the purpose of earning income legally, whereas non-economic activity means it is those activities of human being with the intention of not earning money, but with the intention of affection, love or sympathy towards others. For example, helping a old man to cross the road is non-economic activity. Okay, whereas sale of goods and services is economic activity because its intention is earning of profit. Economic activity further divided into three. One business, second one is profession, next one is employment. In the case of business means economic activity, either production or purchase and sale of goods and services to the consumer for a profit and thereby satisfying consumer wants and needs, so which is called a business. And profession means provision of experts or specialized service by the experts to the client for a charge called fees. Example, doctors, lawyers, engineers, chartered accountant. Employment means a employee giving his service to employer for a contract basis for a particular period for a remuneration called salary or wages or it may be commission. Okay, so this is a nature of the business. Okay, I hope you understood the topic, and notes relating to this topic is to be uploaded to your online